Hi, today we're going to talk about five unique but easy to care for tall indoor plants. Plants somewhere between the length or the height of 3 feet to 6 feet. You can add them to make them a centerpiece of your house. So let's dive in. Number one on my list are alocasias, broad leaves and long beautiful stems that fan out wonderfully. All that this plant needs is good light. See, a lot of times when you go and buy a plant, we ask that is this an indoor plant or an outdoor plant? Now, this can be an outdoor as well as an indoor plant. Just ensure that wherever it is kept, it gets good amount of light, but not direct sun. In fact, for all the plants that you would see have broad leaves, they do not like direct sun falling on them. Rest, just add water whenever the soil dries and repot whenever the roots are coming out from the base of the pot. Now here you would notice that on the top you can see the roots, but this is not a good time to repot the plant. This is about 5 feet, I think 5 feet of plant growing in 10 inch of pot. But since the roots are not coming out from the base, I know that there is more space for these roots to establish themselves. You know, whenever you buy plants from a nursery, don't be in a hurry to repot it. Because whenever you repot or shift the pot for a plant, it undergoes stress. So try and reduce that exposure to stress. Repot only when you're very sure that the roots have no space, and a sign for that is that you check the base of the pot. From these holes, roots should be coming out. Otherwise, don't repot it. Now, the next plant on my list is fiddly fig. If you notice the leaves of this plant, they are also broad like alocasia, but they have like a waxy coating on them. They're somewhat more harder when you look at them or you touch them compared to alocasia. So this plant is somewhat more resistant to dried soil. But for most of these plants that have broader surface, a good rule to follow is that don't let the soil completely dry either. So if you see that the soil is cracky like this, it's not a good sign. Because a simple science law is that bigger the surface area of a leaf, bigger or higher is going to be the rate of evaporation. For all these plants that I cover in today's video, wherever you see broad surface area of the leaf, you have to ensure that neither the water is standing in your soil, it will kill your plant, nor you're letting the soil completely dry like this. This plant needs good light, a bright space like this. So I keep most of them next to this window, but I ensure that the direct sunlight is not falling on this plant. There is a little problem with this plant though. If you're staying in North India, it gets extremely dry in summers, and even in winters it gets very dry. But this plant likes humidity. So if you're staying in Maharashtra, in any part of South India where humidity is higher, this plant will do really well. You would see that the leaves will be budding every week or every month. But if you're staying in a drier state, invest in a diffuser, a humidifier, or you can just spray water on it. It's slightly difficult for this plant to sustain in places that are dry. I know that this plant has become very popular in decor magazines, on Instagram, and everybody wants to have it. So I thought it's worth mentioning that also just see what kind of space or what kind of region you are staying in India to ensure that you don't end up killing it. The third plant, actually a plant that I predict is going to become another showstopper for decor magazines, is this China doll. I guess in past few videos, I have spoken a lot about this plant. This is my recent muse. I love how it looks. It's very fuss-free, very easy to care for. Just ensure that you're watering it properly, as I mentioned before, and for support, because the stems are very delicate, as you can see here, you can add something for support as well. If the plant stops growing, I would suggest that clip it from the top. This will initiate side growth, and within a few weeks, you should see new growth coming out. This plant can also sustain in somewhat medium light spaces, meaning like the inner corner of the house. Another plant that can do well in medium lit space or bright lit space is this cordyline plant. There are a lot of variety of this plant available. It comes in lots of colors. The brighter this space, the more brighter the colors will be. So let's say I have yellow and red one here. If I shift it to a medium light space like the inner side of the house, it might start losing the color. It will sustain well, it will grow well, but it will start losing the color. So I try and keep it here near the window, and I have two varieties, the purple one and this green one. And the care is also exactly the same as the other plants. Now, the fifth kind of plants that I want to talk about is more like a group of plants. These are philodendrons, plants that have these roots coming out of them. So what you can actually do is add a moss stick or stick like this that has a cover on it. So this plant, because of these roots, will be able to climb up, and there are lots of varieties of philodendron. So I have 3-4 varieties, and the surface area of the leaf varies. Broader the leaf, frequent should be watering. So for example, in this one, I add water every 2 to 3 days. But for these, I add water once in a week or 4 or 5 days. Because they're kept indoors, the rate of evaporation is somewhat lesser. But if you keep these plants outdoors, if they're exposed to higher temperature, then you'll have to change the frequency of your watering. A good way is always touch the soil and see how sticky it is. You would get an idea from there that your soil is moist or your soil is completely dry. Philodendrons you can also keep in low light spaces, such as this space. One important thing to notice is that if you see the leaves have become smaller, the new leaves that are coming are smaller in size, move that plant outdoors and add some fertilizer. Within few weeks, you would see that the size of the leaves has changed. They start coming out to be bigger, and then you can shift it back. You know, with indoor plants, you have to go around the house a little bit. You have to move them around. It helps them with their better growth. And you can always use various kinds of planters to keep your plant indoors to make them look stylish. Before I sign off for today's video, I have a quick announcement. At Garden Up Store, now we have a complete range of planters, right from something in straw to metal planters to ceramic planters that come with these teak wood stands. And we are offering a flat 10% discount on all products on Garden Up. The discount coupon is going to be under this video. You can check out the store by clicking the link and use that discount coupon. I will see you very soon. Thanks for watching.